Hello friends, so this is the moment we've been all training for. As you know, the governments, the states, the central banks have wrecked the economy with their endless fiat printing. The world is in ruins, the internet is not working for many days, and what is even worse, I have run out of the PLA filament for my 3D printer. So I need to contact my dealer, and he's a bit of an ass because I need to pay him in advance. So I want to show you how I can do it even though the internet is not working. I have my super secure graphene phone here, and I'm going to use a project that is called Reticulum, which allows me to communicate using these, they're called R nodes. It's a LilyGo LoRa device. And I'm going to share you my screen as well so you can see what I'm doing on my phone. And this device is a long-range radio. Reticulum is not limited to this, but it supports them really well. And the network topology is quite dynamic. So if you have these around the city, the messages will be routed. It is encrypted by default, and it can run over many different mediums. So you can create Ethernet links, you can do it over Wi-Fi, over I2P if you have internet, which I don't have right now. So on this phone you can see I'm in airplane mode, there's no network, and I'm going to write to my dealer using a program called Sideband, which is an end-to-end encrypted text chat over this network. So I'm going to write him, yo bro, do you have some PLA for me? Okay, punctuation is really important even during apocalypse. So my phone is connected to this R node using Bluetooth. So when I hit send, you can see that the green light starts blinking and it's sending. Hopefully I can reach him somehow. As you can see, it's quite slow. That is configurable. I'm using a spreading factor of 10. So it's delivered. This is really over radio. There's really no internet between these devices. So let's wait for the dealer to write back.
So, it's blinking. Let's see. Okay. Two sets for black kilo of black filament. Give me black for sets. Here are the sets. Okay, so what I'm going to use now is a project that I wrote over past few weeks, days actually, and it's a Cashu implementation that also works over Reticulum and LXMF. You can find it on my GitHub while there's still no apocalypse. So please download it. Anyway, I am, because I was not able to compile it to an APK yet, even though it's written in Kivi, which is a multi-platform user interface, has some C dependencies. I was not able to compile it. I'm going to show it to you on my laptop, and let's create an eCash token and send it over Reticulum, so over the sideband. So let me show you. So what I'm doing now is I'm opening the app. It's written in pure Python. As you can see, I am rich. I have 6 Satoshi, and I'm loading the mint, which is refreshing the key sets. And let's see. Takes a while. It's really low bandwidth, and it's really going through the radio, so no internet. And after I finish, after it finishes loading, I can send some sets. So this is a very basic user interface. So what I do is I write in this input box how many sets token. I got a reply from the mint. Perfect. It's gonna be hopefully quicker now. So now I'm going to write how many sets token I want to create, and it changes it with the mint. I'm going to send him just 1 set. I don't need whole kilo filament to spend 2 or 3 sets. I am splitting the tokens and refreshing them with the mint, and I get back this weird string, which I can copy and paste and send it to as a string to the dealer, and he will just paste it here and click on receive. And to prevent double spends, he needs to exchange it with the mint as well. So he will send the tokens to the mint and refresh and get a fresh token. So this is happening right now. I'm just showing it how it works, what he sees and how he receives the token. So he pasted it over. He got it from me through sideband, he's receiving the he received the tokens, he pastes it into the Nutband app, clicks receive, and he will refresh it with the mint and have a fresh tokens that I cannot spend anymore. So spending sats over Cashu and using the mints is a bit different than sending sats over the Lightning Network. Cashu is compatible with the Lightning Network. That's the way how the coins are created. So that's what you can actually do. And once you have the tokens, it's just a string. But in order to prevent double spend, when I receive this string, it's a signed token by the mint. When I receive it, I have to exchange it with the mint, so the sender cannot spend it twice, and it's only mine. What is nice about this is that this is all encrypted, all peer-to-peer. There's no centralized infrastructure. There are just nodes like this, and they communicate with each other. And this one is quite far from my car, where I spent this fiat cost apocalypse. And that's how it basically works. So stack sets, don't get caught up in the middle of this fiat apocalypse. Save and play with cool cypherpunk decks such as eCash means. I think it's important to look at other options. eCash has beautiful anonymity. It doesn't need interactive communication for sending and receiving. You can just send someone a string. I have even gifted Cashu to people I gave my book to. So I have this small thermal printer. I minted a token. I created a QR code. I printed it and I stuck it on my book. In the book, I also write about a few post-apocalyptic things, such as how to build peer-to-peer payment networks on top of Bitcoin. I was using Lightning back then. I would use probably eCash and some kind of infrastructure such as Reticulum. It's beautiful. I highly recommend you start playing with it. It's fun to build these networks with friends in the city. It's not as easy, but not as hard. So this device costs $20 to $40 dollars or euros. There are different bands that and you are allowed to use it. It's very slow, so throughput of a few kilobits per second. Make sure to get a good antenna, and you can cover the whole city with these. Of course, you can use other technology. There is going to be a new technology that is a new Wi-Fi standard, which is called, I think, Halo. And this will allow faster speeds up to 1 kilometer distance. So compared to standard Wi-Fi in 5 gigahertz, this will cover a wider area. What you can do as well is use these radios to connect, let's say, villages among each other, and then this node can have a Wi-Fi access point in a public square or something. So what you can do in sideband, I will go back to the app. What you can do here is go to activity, and you can connect via local Wi-Fi or Ethernet. So that allows you to see the node that is directly connected through Wi-Fi. You don't need to configure IP addresses, nothing. It will just see the node and use it. So if you are in a public square that has one of these nodes for uplink, you can just connect it to it with your phone, and there's no additional hardware necessary. If the communication is locally within the village, you will just talk to each other via the Wi-Fi, but you can also send a message to someone in another village, and the node will route it. And if it's two villages away, there will be it will route. So the topology is very nice. It's very very peer-to-peer, very mesh. And it works quite nice. You can also connect, as I said in the beginning, via TCP, I2P. This is the R node connection, which goes through Bluetooth. By the way, this is just a battery bank. You can power it with any USB, micro USB source. And it needs to connect to a smart device, although there is a routing node that runs just on this device in the works. But currently it needs to connect either via Bluetooth or via USB to a computer that is able to do the encryption and routing. So that's all, folks. If you want to go beyond the moon and the price of Bitcoin and learn more about how this cool cypherpunk tech works, not Reticulum in particular, I recommend you visit or read two of my books. One is Cypherpunk Vision and Trends 2023 to 2025. I wrote it last year in January, where I was looking at some cypherpunk tech that I would like to see develop, and I made some, not necessarily predictions, but I've been noticing some trends, and I wanted to put a vision out there of what we should work on and what I would like to see in the world. It talks about things such as alternative lifestyles in camper vans, such as this one, solar power that I have on the roof here, about local first artificial intelligence, very cool, less centralized and more self-sovereign social networks, such as Noster, and some other things. And also I've been talking about mesh networks and running your own nodes and all the cool stuff like that. And then there's more practical and present anchored in present book, which is called Cryptocurrencies, Hack Your Way to a Better Life, where I explain what you can use this crypto tech for. It's mostly about Bitcoin, but I also talk about some other use cases such as collateralized loans, because it's cool to short fiat and long Bitcoin. I talk about encrypted messengers and many other things. So it's a fun but longer read. But if you want to go beyond just simple, HODL use case or whatever, buy the ETF and wait for the moon, I recommend this book for implementing cryptocurrencies, crypto technologies, cypherpunk technologies, Bitcoin in your life. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.